Yo, what's good? It's your boy St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com, Big Bitch Friday. Today, checking out Darkness. It's part two from the cinematic sound design. I did a review on that one a while ago, but this is part two. And it's made up of a bunch of, you know, cinematic loops and sounds and effects. But this one, there's no synths used in it. You know, it's mostly, you know, dumpsters and metal. You see metal bridges, cables, and stringed instruments. And, you know, it's just a lot of real acoustic sources. So I got it pulled up in Kontakt. It's part of the KLI series. So it's got the Kontakt interface. And I'm going to just go through them. So let's listen what they sound like. So they definitely got a really, really awesome tone to them, being based on acoustic sources. But another thing to remember is you still get all the loops, the wave loops, so you can load the waves directly in your sampler or whatever, chop them up, do whatever you want to do. Let's go to the next one. And remember, just like all the other KLI interfaces, you can still go in and mess with the different effects on these. So if you wanted to rotate them or whatever, say we turn that on. So you get the idea. I mean, I can still go in and mess with, you know, maybe some flanger. Just turn that on and see. So it lets you take your loops and quickly, you know, mess with them, affect them, and different stuff like that. So I really dig the tone and the texture of these sounds. They have a really gritty, abrasive, you know, I guess it's from those acoustic sources. It's really, they sound really organic and abrasive and gritty and, you know, real. Let's see what else we got. Those were the loops, combos. Let's check out some of the slice loops. So again, these are the slice loops. I'm not going to go through all of them, but you get the idea with them. Remember how they work. So let's you play the slices. If I wanted to mess with the pitch of just this one. And I don't want to mess with the cutoff of this one, let's say. So you get the idea with that, and it's pretty much, you got all the loops that I played previously, all the noise loops and everything, each one's chopped up now. If you want to see your chops. That's with the volume. You see right here, you can drag your MIDI into your DAW or whatever. So you get the idea with that. Let's get to some of these other ones. You already heard these when I was kind of going through them in the main patch, but again, you still get each one chopped up. And of course, like I said, you get all the waves. So These are the processed ones. And of course, you still got all your instrument, you got all your effects that you can use as well. So I like the, I prefer the other loops over the processed ones. I like, you know, just the general noise loops. Let's see what we got in here. So you see, you can quickly start messing around with different stuff. Bunch of loops and stuff in here. And then you also got some, let's find the, there they go, sound effects menus. So, got quite a few of these in here as well. And these sound pretty good. So, definitely some usable stuff right there. See, we got a few different menus as well. Definitely some useful sound design elements here. These are probably my favorite part of the library, the sound effects. See what else we got in here. Different hits and impacts. Some really big impacts, really useful stuff. So get you some nice sound design elements at a good price. Like I said, there's a lot in here, and you still, I like to show them off in the Kontakt interface because I think it's pretty cool, but you still get all the direct waves, so you get all this stuff as just regular waves that you can load up in your sampler or whatever. Just some really, really dope stuff. So. Risers. Of course, you know me, this is the type of stuff can be used in any type of music, not just for cinema and film and stuff, and you know, you could throw it in your urban, electronic, dubstep, whatever. It's just another source of sounds, but as you can hear, they got some really, really cool stuff in there. Stuff sounds dope, man. Like I said, the sound effects menus are my favorite. And we're right back. So that's pretty much it. I went through the loops and some of the slice loops, the combo loops, and then some of the sound effects menu really sounds awesome. Again, the Kontakt interface makes it very useful, very quick to get in and start messing with stuff. But of course, you still got the raw waves, so you can just go take those, put those in your sampler, chop them up, re-effect them, re-slice them, do whatever you want to them. But yeah, man, just the raw data that's here, the raw sounds, the very organic, have a very, you know, just raw, techie, grungy acoustic sound to them, which I really, really dig. Gives a nice contrast when you're building them in there with synths and other stuff like that. So it brings a lot of different textures to the table. So yeah, man, I like it. Sounds good. It's $69. You get a lot of stuff in here. It's like 2.8 gigs of sounds. I'm gonna give this a 4.5 out of 5, man. I love it. I like the other one, and Darkness is just part two. So hopefully they keep doing these, man, because they really capture some really cool sounds, really useful stuff. And I like the flexibility of either loading it in Kontakt or just loading the Wave or Rex or whatever you want to load directly in your sampler or DAW. So make sure you go check it out. Also, make sure you download the free sample pack that they have over there on Big Fish Audio. Just go there, look for Darkness, or look on my post and you'll see the link to it. So definitely check it out. This is your boy St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. 4.5 out of 5 subs. Darkness, cinematic sound design. It's definitely not just for film and media, but it's very useful for that. But anybody that likes to use different and creative sounds, definitely check this out. So let me know what you think. All right, peace.